Go ahead and begin.
Looking to spice up your life by extracting key components from blood, urine, or other bodily fluids? Then solid phase microextraction can bring you just that. Although this may not be your dream occupation, you can learn a lot about solid phase microextraction and the many ways it can be used every day. By understanding why it is needed, taking a deeper look into the actual process, and understanding the potential it has, you might be able to consider yourself a micro-expert on solid phase microextraction. So why is SPME needed? SPME is an abbreviation for solid phase microextraction, and I will be using it today, so I do not take 10 minutes. My brother uses SPME most days as part of his daily lab work. So I have been familiar with it for a couple of years. Marcelino Verona, a grad student studying chemistry at Iowa State, said, "The world needs SPME as an analysis method as new and complex problems which require the analysis of chemicals are discovered. New chemicals are discovered every year, which can be harmful for human consumption. The challenge is identifying and determining the amount of the chemicals present in environmental sources, or even in the human body. SPME can be used as a tool to tackle these problems." SPME is used to prepare a substance before it is used in chromatography. But what is chromatography? Chromatography serves to separate the components in a substance so they can be analyzed separately. Chromatography works by moving chemicals to a stationary phase that they like so that they stay in it. So basically, SPME extracts it so that chromatography can separate it and analyze it further. SPME has many advantages. In the article titled "Effects of Soil Composition and Solid Phase Microextraction Determination for Triazine and Organophosphorus Pesticides" by Rada Dorvic from the Institute of Pesticides and Environmental Protection in Belgrade, Serbia, mentioned that SPME does not require an organic solvent like other methods. Solvents are expensive and in some cases dangerous to the environment. Cutting the solvent out creates a better overall environment. SPME is also considered simple, fast, and an inexpensive technique. It only needs a small amount rather than a large sample like the other techniques. While this can be a disadvantage because you cannot create a large sample in one, it is very good for lab work because you can create small samples of multiple things and test it and see which one will work best. Dorovic states that considering new developments in SPME devices and fibers, and the fact that SPME can integrate sampling, extraction, concentration, and purification into a single step, into a high sample throughput, SPME seems to be a very promising technique. So basically, SPME is like the family combo of the science world. It combines four into one. SPME is an innovative and useful technique, but to understand it further, you need to know the actual process of SPME. The actual process is described by Fritz Prags from the Berlin Institute in his article "Application of Solid Phase Microextraction in Analytical Toxicology." He wrote, "Solid phase microextraction is a miniaturized and solvent-free sample preparation technique for chromatographic spectrometric analysis. But we use the analytes are extracted from a gaseous or liquid sample by absorption in or absorption on a thin polymer coating fixed to a solid surface of a fiber inside an injection needle or through a capillary." As good Lutherans, you should be asking yourself, what does this mean? The first part is the coating. You can now look at your visual aid, and you will see in the first number, letter A, the coating is around the fiber, a syringe, or a capillary. The coating can be very different, and it is what helps the extraction process. So depending on how good your coating is how effective your extraction process will be. The other part is the fiber and the sealed needles. The fibers are coated and placed inside the sealed needle. This is to protect them and to help the extraction process. Fibers are commonly used silica. You can also see these in letter B and letter C. They're coated and placed inside for chromatography. The fibers are 1 centimeter long and 1 million micrometers in 1 meter. The fibers are then used to extract the chemicals and wood substance. That's all the visually superficial. The process of SPME may be confusing, but SPME is necessary and has many uses. Durovic used SPME in a study to determine pesticides in compositions of dirt. Different samples of dirt were taken in for a lab, and each studied exactly the same. SPME was used to extract the pesticides from the dirt to see how much and how many of each pesticide there was in the samples. Krags mentioned SPME used for toxicology, specifically forensic toxicology. They used SPME on blood, urine, tissue to see extract the toxic or the crucial part so they could analyze it and compare it to the other samples that they had and therefore make matches. It also helped them create a better idea of the crime scene overall. Verona used SPME to extract DNA from artificial sputum samples, and the SPME was crucial for the rapid capture of DNA. He also included a visual detection so the naked eye could see when the extraction was successful. By gaining knowledge about this technique, you have acquired a better understanding and appreciation for SPME. Now you then need for SPME, how it works, and the many uses it has. Before today, you probably didn't know what SPME was. During my speech, well, you probably didn't care too much either, but you never know where you might be in 10 years. You might really well be using SPME to make some groundbreaking discoveries.
Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause. Thank you, Helen. And I've got your time.